More and more children are out of school, but parents don't want math learning to stop. They're turning to Mathnasium at home. Real-time math instruction tailored to your child's exact educational needs. It's the same face-to-face live instruction used in our centers for over 15 years, now on a computer. Your child can keep their math skills sharp, catch up, or soar ahead, from home or anywhere with an internet connection. To learn if Mathnasium at home is right for your child, visit mathnasium.com/at home. Mathnasium at home, changing lives through math.
Hi everyone, and welcome back to Mathnasium Schoolhouse. Nice to see you guys saying hello already. Thank you so much for that. Feel free to add in your comments as well what grade you're in, if you are in fact a student. Maybe I should specify, since it is the summertime, maybe what grade you will be in as of September. So go ahead and share that with us. I'd love to know who's joining us, what level you guys are at. Maybe that will help me really understand the knowledge you're coming in with. Because of course, when you join us at Mathnasium, whether you are already one of our students, which is wonderful, or you're planning to join, it's always helpful to know from our side of things what knowledge you're coming in with through information such as what grade level, what grade you're in school, and what it is that you do know on topics such as time, which is exactly what we're exploring today. So the way that we're going to do this is you've had a worksheet that's been shared with you in the description of this video. I can give you a few seconds, a minute or two to pull that up if you'd like to follow along with it. If you followed any of my videos, lessons before through Mathnasium Schoolhouse, I will also share with those questions with you on screen, so there's no need for you to pull it up just yet, but I'll leave that up to you. So we'll go through that, and it'll be a mix of problems that have to deal with elapsed time, which is exactly what we're talking about today. I kind of created a creative title for today, which is Time is Passing By, and we're going to be looking at how to really be able to tell how many minutes, how many hours and minutes pass by when we know the start time and we know when we want it to end. So that's what we're looking at. I'm hoping that those of you that are joining us today have that base knowledge of being able to tell time, both through a digital clock, and so when I write out the time, but I'll also pull up my handy dandy clock manipulative here for those of you that need to visualize it, at least for the first few questions. If you have one at home and you want to follow along, go right ahead, bring that up. I'm just gonna take a look at the comments here. Oh, you don't see the worksheet? I believe I do. Oh, maybe it's not. You know what? How about you do this? I saw it on the Facebook page itself. So you're right. I don't see it in the description on my screen right now. If you go to the page, there is a link there. And maybe one of my helpers will help me out here and just add it into the comments in just a second. All right. But thank you for letting me know that. I see fourth grade. How long will this be? About 30 minutes, 35 minutes. We'll see how much you guys help me out with the answers. You'll be in first grade. Wonderful. Very nice. Got a nice mixture here. Going into fifth grade on September the 1st. Very nice. Oh, you're not good at time? Well, that's wonderful that you're here. Maybe some of you are great at it. You personally feel very confident in it and you just want more practice, so you'll help us out. For those of you that don't feel too comfortable, hopefully this helps in that. All right. Thank you so much for the helper that linked the worksheet there. So take a look at that. I am going to go to my whiteboard screen right now. And let's start this discussion about elapsed time. So let me pull out a marker here. So as I said, that's what we're looking at here. And so a few pieces of information we should know before looking at how much time has passed by is, of course, being able to tell time from a clock, being able to identify how many minutes are passing by as the hands go all around the clock. So information such as that is going to be super helpful for right now, because as I said, the problems that we're going to be working with in particular look like this. We'll identify a start time and then an end time, and we want to know how much time has passed by in between there. All right. So let's take a look at the PDF here. I'm going to pull it up and we'll start with some basic questions and then get into some more complex ones. So if you have that worksheet with you, wonderful. You can follow along. Let me just erase this here. And let's take a look at question number one. So as always, I welcome you all to help me out with the answers by just commenting. And I will be taking a look at the comments here and there. So question number one, we're looking at what time is it 20 minutes before 8:40? So maybe before we jump into that, I'm going to get off the page here for just a second. Before we jump into question number one, what if I asked you, it's typically easier for us to talk about time as it's passing by, so minutes after a certain time, because we know that time goes forward. So talking about time before is just a little bit strange for us, but that's fine. So you guys are already giving me the correct answer. Beautiful, I appreciate it. What if I asked you 20 minutes after? Let's do that first before we answer question number one. Okay, so if I pull out my clock, and we don't have to do this for every question, but let's just do it for this one, just so that you guys can see how this looks here. I am going to, just for a split second, I'm going to ignore the fact that it's a.m., just for now, and I'm just going to identify the 8:40 time on my clock. So if I do that, you guys can tell me where I have to land, but I have to go all around. So I'm going to go to not 8 o'clock, but 8:40. And so if you look at the multiples of 5 here, if I do that, there we go, 8:40. What happens if I want to find the time 20 minutes after? Well, since we're going through multiples of 5, I can go 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. And as you guys are already sharing, it is 9 o'clock. So 20 minutes after would be, in fact, 9 o'clock. So now let's go to 20 minutes before, and you guys are sharing the correct answer with me, which is 8:20, and you're also showing me that it's 8:20 a.m. Beautiful, because maybe the best way for me to put this is we've only looked at minutes before, so we haven't passed yet that 12 o'clock, which would possibly change for us between the a.m. and the p.m., and we'll see problems with that in particular, okay? So let me remove this here and go to question number one. And as you guys said, 20 minutes before 8:40 a.m. would in fact be 8:20 a.m. And for those of you that need to visualize it, which is fine, we won't do this for all the problems, but let's just do it here. So if I have 8:40, okay, just there, and I look at 20 minutes before, let's go through the multiples of 5 one more time. 5, 10, 15, 20. So if Sandra has the hand correctly on the 20 there, it is in fact 8:20. Okay? We haven't passed by any hour yet. It's only been 20 minutes within that 8 o'clock hour. Perfect. All right. Let's move on then. Glad to see the correct answers here. After 12 o'clock is p.m. Yes, thank you, Amita, or if it's someone else on the account, thank you for sharing that. We're going to use that piece of knowledge soon. So let's go to question number two here. If the current time is 5:45 p.m., how long will it be until the time is 9:45 p.m.? So now you can start to see from our start time to our end time, we have in fact passed through some hours. Okay, so how long will it be until that end time of 9:45 p.m.? Let me take a look at the comments here. Give you guys a few seconds to think about that. 4 hours I'm seeing, very nice. Let's see if anyone else, yeah, I'm seeing a few more of those same answers. That is correct, it is 4 hours. And how do we know that? Sure, I can pull up my clock and visualize that. Or I can simply see that if I start, let me write the start here, at 5:45. So I'm starting at a p.m. and I'm getting back to a p.m. So I know that some amount of hours, let's do this. Okay, 9:45 p.m. Half passed by, and I know it's going to be hours because I'm still at the 45-minute mark for both ends, for both the starting and the end, okay? So now it's a matter, and you can count this different ways. I think my personal favorite since I was a young student was to count, okay, 5:45, so the next 60 minutes after would be 6:45, 7:45, 8:45, 9:45. Okay, so it has been, in fact, 4 hours that have passed. All right. You can, I'm going to say the word subtraction here. It's a bit scary to perform that subtraction if you don't, what's the best way to put this? If you forget that you're looking at time, it can get a bit iffy. So just, you can perform the subtraction in your head, 9:45, and I subtract some amount of hours to get to 5:45. You can do that if you're comfortable with it, or you can count up the way that I did it, okay? It's not 4 hours and 45 minutes because we started at 45 minutes and we ended at 45 minutes, but that is in the evening. Yeah, great. 240 minutes, wow, very nice way to put it as well. Yeah, we could talk about how many minutes have passed by or just hours. So that's a great way to kind of extend your thinking as well here. Perfect. So let me erase this and jump to question number 3 then. Let me show you 3 and 4. We'll do those two together. Let's do it this way. Yeah. Okay. So what time is it if it's 25 minutes after 7:15 p.m.? Go ahead and try that out. Write down number 3 here. 25 minutes after 7:15. So if it's only 25 minutes after 7:15, my brain starts to think, okay, so I'm not jumping to a.m. yet. I'm sticking within p.m. because I'm only working with minutes. Not only that, I'm working within the 60 minutes of an hour. So I'm not even going to go to the next hour, which would be 8 o'clock. So that's great. Not even 60 minutes. I should say 45 minutes, but that's fine. So if I'm starting at 7:15, my marker's going to run out. Let's use a different one here. 7:15. And I want to know the end. What is this end if 25 minutes are passing by? 25 minutes. And I see the answer already appearing. Beautiful. James, great job. Oh, and a bunch of you. I just scrolled down. Very nice. Yes, it is going to be 7:40. Okay, and it'll be 7:40 p.m. Let's specify that. How do we know that? I can pull up my clock if needed, or I can visualize even within my head. Okay, I have it at the 15-minute mark, which, forget about the hour for now, it's at the 15-minute mark, so that's a quarter after the hour. Okay, if I add 25 minutes, a few ways you can kind of think of this is 25 minutes, it's kind of a creative way to do it, but it's the way that I like to do it in my head, is composed of 15 plus 10. 15 is another quarter, wonderful, so I get to half past the hour. Then I have 10 more minutes, but 30 plus 10 is 40, which, again, ignore the hour, it's not correct here, but you'll get to 7:40. Okay? Another way you could possibly do it, if you want to get creative in your head, is 25 is 30 minus 5. So if I have a quarter past the hour and I add another 30 minutes, I know that's going to get me to 3/4 past the hour or a quarter to the next hour. So I would go to that, which is the 45-minute mark, but that's 5 minutes more than I need to be at, so it's actually at the 40. Different ways you can do it. You could also just add 25 to 15 and you get there, okay? Perfect. I see you guys are done. With the answers. Wonderful. So let's jump to number four then here. So that was 740. Let's jump to number four. So it's on the screen there. If the current time is 1:35 p.m., how long will it be until the time is 1:55? Let's see if I have any answers here. I'm seeing a few of them coming in now. Perfect. So we can take a look at this. So if we start at 1:35 p.m., I'm just going to put S for start, and I'm going to put E for end. We're ending at p.m. No information told us it's the next day, so I don't have to take that into account. So we're sticking within that hour. And so we understand, hopefully by now, that it's only minutes that have passed by. I'm still at the 1 hour. We know it's not the next day, so there's some amount of minutes that have just passed by. Probably the easiest way for me to do it, and possibly for you guys, if you want to share what you have done, those of you that have gotten the correct answer, which is 20 minutes, is just to perform the subtraction. 55 minutes minus the 35 minutes does in fact give you the 20 minutes that have passed by. Okay. Maybe you decided to instead count upwards with multiples of five. So I could kind of keep track of that with tallies if I wanted to. 35 to the next 5 minute mark is 40. 40 to 45. 45 to 50. 50 to 55. I had four multiples of five, which gives me 20. So that's one way to do it. And if you guys care to share, how you got your answer, I'd love to see if it's anything different from the way that I'm thinking. So let's move on to question number five then. And I'll pull up five and six for you guys to see. Go ahead and try those two out. Here we're being asked to find the time before the end time, meaning, what time is it 3 hours before 9:30 p.m.? Okay, so whereas before we were working a lot with time or minutes after, we knew the end time and we knew the start time, so we wanted to see how much time has passed by. Here we want to know what is that start time from the end time. Hope that's not too confusing the way I'm putting that. But what is this start time? If here I have 9:30 p.m. as my end, E is just my end, and 3 hours have passed by. Let's see what you guys are saying here. Yeah, I'm seeing the right one. 6:30, and for those of you, oh, I just saw a beautiful comment. Yes. So for those of you that are specifying that it's PM, I truly appreciate that because that'll come in handy for our next set of problems coming up. We should be very specific if it's AM or PM. But here, we haven't passed by that 12-hour point that someone had helped me out with earlier. That would change it from PM to AM. How do we know that? For those of you that are helping me in saying 9 minus 3 is 6, that's absolutely correct. So we do in fact get to 6:30 p.m. Okay, and I love the way, who was it that put it? Arav, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, you kind of wrote it really creatively there. You said 9 minus 3, 30. equals 6:30. I like that. I like the way you wrote that out. It both gives me the answer and the way that you thought about it. So thank you for that. Very, very nice. And you guys are already on the next question. Yay. So let's jump to number six here. If the current time is 4:25 a.m., so I'm just going to write that down while I have that in my mind. So if the current time is 4:25 a.m., how long will it be until my end point, which is 4:40 a.m. So how much time? And you guys are sharing with me 15 minutes. Very nice. How did you get that? I don't think I saw anyone explain the reasoning just yet, but I'm going to make one assumption that possibly you put a few pieces of information, then you perform some subtraction. So you said, okay, I'm within the 4 hours, great, and I'm also within the AM, and nothing told me I'm on the next day or anything like that. So I'm sticking within the same hour, which means I can jump to the minutes and only perform subtraction from the minutes, which means 25 minutes to 40 minutes is in fact 15 minutes that have passed by, which is what you all are sharing with me. Perfect. Very nice. Okay. Yeah, Amita is sharing great information here. So after 12 o'clock is PM to the afternoon, and after 12 o'clock is AM to the late night. Great. Thank you for that. And Rekka said, I subtracted 440 minus 425 to get 15 minutes. Yes, so you looked at the time specifically. And Arav, again, gave us a beautiful explanation there. Perfect. So let's jump to the next two questions. I'm going to show you 7 and 8. So number 7 tells us to look for, well, what time is it 45 minutes after 2:05 a.m.? So let's maybe just write down the answers here. I won't write out maybe some of the thinking just yet, but what time is it 45 minutes after 2:05 a.m.? Let's see what you guys have here. So what do we have here? 45 minutes after 2:05 a.m. Well, one way to think of it, and there we go, I'm seeing the answers appearing, is I'm only looking at 45 minutes past 2:05. So whether it's AM or PM, I could pull out my clock, show 2:05, and then go through multiples of 5, 45 minutes down, and I will end up at exactly 2:50 a.m., which is what you all are sharing with me. Beautiful. Is there another way we could possibly look at this? Maybe if you want it to be super creative, and this is just the way that you think, which is perfectly fine. 45 minutes is 15 minutes less than 60 minutes. Why is that helpful to me? Well, 60 minutes is a full hour. So 45 minutes is a quarter less than that. That's helpful to me because if I want to think of time that way, a full 60 minutes or a full hour past 2:05 would be 3:05, but I don't want a full 60 minutes, I don't want a full hour, I want only three quarters or a quarter less than a full hour. So I can subtract 15 minutes from that 3:05. If you followed along with that reasoning, great, that's probably the way that you're thinking about it in your mind. You can keep at that, there's no issue with that, or you can count forward the 45 minutes as we did. Okay. Cool, let's jump to number 8 then, which asks us, if the current time is 11:10 p.m., how long will it be until the time is 11:45 p.m.? So one more time, I don't want to keep on repeating it too much for those of you that do understand it, but I will say it one more time. I'm just verifying for myself, or confirming, I should say, I'm within the 2 p.m.s. I'm not moving to the next day. Great. I'm also within the same hour. Wonderful. So it looks like only minutes have passed by. And how many minutes? Let's see. I don't see it just yet. I just saw it. 35 minutes. That's exactly right. And let's confirm that. So if the current time is 11:10, we can count by multiples of 5. I don't want to pull out my fingers, but that's kind of the way that I'm thinking about it in my mind, right? 11:10 to 11:30, maybe I could say is 20 minutes. 11:30 to 11:40 is another 10 minutes. Great. So 20 plus 10 is 30. Okay. And then 11:40 to 11:45 is 5 minutes. And there I got 35 minutes. Okay. So I could just count forward that way. I could also do the subtraction. Sure. I could take the 45 minutes, subtract the 10 minutes that have already passed by, pass the hour, and get 35. So a few different ways we can do it. Okay. Very cool. Let's look at the last two questions on the first follow-along page, so numbers 9 and 10, before we move on to some additional problems. So let's look at number 9 and 10 here. Maybe I'll give you a few seconds to think through those answers before I kind of lead us to the correct one. So, what time is it 15 minutes before 6:50 a.m.? What time is it 15 minutes before? So I'm not going to go past. So remember this. We have to be very careful about what it's asking us. Is it before or after? Let's look at after. After. We'll do that one together. So let's look at 15 minutes before 6:50. So if I'm starting at 6:50, I'm kind of going backwards with time. And I'm trying to find what time was it 15 minutes before. So I know that I'm not going to go past the hour, so great. I could just take the minutes, which is 50 minutes, subtract 15 from there. And if you do that, you will end up at 35 minutes, which means my answer is 6:35 a.m. So very much like when we look at measurement questions, we need to specify the units of measure. Kind of think of it the same way here. We need to specify if it's a.m. or p.m. just to be conscious of what, how far we've gone before or after with our time. Great. Thank you, James, for sharing. Maria, very nice. So it is 6:35 a.m. What if I asked you, so this is not on the page, but it kind of leads us to the next set of questions. What if I asked you instead, what if I asked you, what time is it 15 minutes after 6:50 a.m.? Just a little bit of a challenge before we move on. 15 minutes after 6:50 a.m. So 6:50 is 10 minutes to the next hour, which would be 7 a.m. So if we're going to count 15 minutes, that's 10 plus 5. So we actually hit that next hour. And we have 5 minutes left over. So that would actually be 7:05 a.m. We'll look at more of those problems in just a second. But challenge yourself to think before and after. And then number 10, if the current time is 3:20 a.m., how long will it be until the time is 4 o'clock? Or I should be specific, 4 o'clock a.m. Let me take a look at the comments here. You guys are absolutely correct. It is 40 minutes. And again, there could be several ways you get to this answer. 3:20, the next hour would in fact be 4 a.m. So I'm only looking at the minutes that have passed by from 3:20 to 4 a.m., which is in fact 40 minutes. And I could confirm that by counting 5 minutes on my clock manipulative. Or I can understand, I can take my knowledge of the fact that the hour mark is represented by 60 minutes. 60 subtract 20 is 40 minutes. A few ways you can do that. All right. And Pinjo gave me a beautiful explanation for this question here that we did together. 6:50 plus 10 minutes is 7 a.m. plus 5 minutes is 7:05. Thank you for sharing that. I appreciate it. Beautiful. You guys are right on it with the 40 minutes. Perfect. So then I'm aware of the time. Let's do a few questions from the second page here where we'll encounter more of those issues is not a bad thing. It's just we have to keep in mind if we're jumping from AM to PM or anything of the sort. So let's keep that in mind specifically for this second page here. So let's look at question number 11. What time will it be 25 minutes after 7:55 a.m.? And there we go. We're already encountering something similar to that challenge we just did here. Am I jumping to p.m. just yet? Hopefully your first thought is no, because we're only looking at 25 minutes after 7:55. That doesn't get us anywhere near 12 o'clock, which would make us consider if we're changing from a.m. to p.m., let me put it that way. So if I'm only going 25 minutes past 7:55, I'm going to use the reasoning that I believe it was Pinjo that shared with us in the comments, a very similar structure to how they wrote it out for us. 25 minutes, if I break that down, I can break it down to a few sums, but I'm going to break it down purposefully into 5 minutes plus the remainder, which is 20 minutes. And you might wonder why I decided to do that. For some of you, it might be very apparent. And the reason is I have 7:55. I'm going to ignore the AM and PM stuff just yet. We had that conversation, so we know we're still going to be in AM for our final answer. But the next hour will, in fact, be 8 o'clock AM. And to get to that next hour, I need 5 minutes, which means I have 20 minutes left over after that. So wonderful. I get to 8:20. And let's see if you guys are sharing that as well. Yeah. Pull up your comments here. 8:20. Very nice. Okay. So it is 8:20. Let me just circle this here. And 8:20 a.m., I should say. So that is the final answer. And I could see you guys are sharing it, so that's great. And I see question number 12. You guys are already working on that, so let's do that. I'm just going to erase this. Hopefully you guys follow along there. If I erase that and jump to number 12 here, you guys are sharing with me. And again, Arav, I love your explanations. Very, very nice. All right, so let's see. If the current time is 3:20 p.m., how long will it be until the time is 4:05 p.m.? And I saw the answer a few times already, 45 minutes, very nice. A few ways we can do this. I believe in one of the previous problems, we looked at 3:20 a.m. until 4 a.m., and we told ourselves that that was 40 minutes. Here we're just going slightly over that hour mark by 5 minutes. And yes, we're sticking within the PM timing, but that doesn't make a difference in terms of the minutes that have passed by. So to get from 3:20 to 4:05, it is in fact, I'm gonna write it out this way. 40 minutes plus 5 minutes, which is 45 minutes. And I just wrote it out that way because that's the way that it made sense in my mind. That's how I kind of found the answer in my mind. I went to the next hour, which would have been 4 o'clock, and then we're looking at 5 minutes past that hour. So 40 minutes plus five minutes gives me that total 45 minutes. Beautiful. Let's move on to questions 13 and 14. Very nice. So let's go here. Let's see how much of these we can go through. Number 13. What time will it be, and here's a fraction, don't get scared, 1.5 hours after 4:45 a.m.? So although it's a fraction, which might seem scary, I really hope it's not, it's actually a beautiful fraction. Because when it comes to time, thinking about a full hour is super easy, I would hope. Once you get a hang of it, I should say. And half hours are the next favorite, I would say. So if I think about 1.5 hours after 4:45 a.m., my mind, and you guys can let me know if you think of it the same way, before I write anything down, mentally the way that I do this is I break it up into 1 hour and a half hour. And hours, like I said, are typically the most favorite. Then comes the half hour. So let's do this together. 4:45 a.m., a full hour past that would be 5:45 a.m. Okay, so I'm going to keep that in my mind. Then a half hour past 5:45 a.m. A few ways you can think about this. A half hour is composed of 2 quarter hours. And the reason you might prefer that way of thinking is because a quarter of an hour will take you to 6 o'clock a.m. And then the next quarter will get you to 6:15 a.m. Or you might just already be super comfortable with visualizing and counting time with the half hour as it is. And you know that half hour past some o'clock and 45 minutes gives you to the next hour and 15 minutes. So a few ways you can think about it, but regardless, let's see if you guys are sharing the correct answer here. amongst all the other comments that I'm seeing. Hopefully we can all stay on topic here. But it is in fact 6:15. There we go. I see Amita's comment. Yes, the final answer is 6:15 a.m. Beautiful. That's exactly right. So don't get confused by my 5:45 here. This was just 1 hour past, 1 hour after, and then I accounted for that extra half hour. If you didn't follow along there, you can always come back to this video, pause it, and resume after you've kind of understood my explanations. Okay? Or as always, as I always recommend, reach out to your nearest Mathnasium, and we have more, a ton of instructors that would be more than happy to help you with time and any other topics you're interested in. So let's do a few more here. Let's look at number 14. Okay, if the current time is 6:50 a.m., how long will it be until the time is 10:15 a.m.? Oh my goodness, we are jumping quite far, right? We're not even looking at 7 o'clock. We've jumped through 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. We're jumping to 10 o'clock. But I'm comforted by the fact that we're sticking within the a.m.s. So that's nice. So I might just visualize this in my mind a few different ways. No, I'm not going to write anything down just yet. I try to do this mentally. 6:50 to 7:50 is 1 hour. 7:50 to 8:50 would be 2 hours. 8:50 to 9:50 would be 3 hours. Did I count that right? No. 7:50, 8:50, 9:50. So that's 3 hours already. Yeah. And then what do we have? Okay, I'm seeing a few of the answers. I'm seeing a 4 hours, not quite. I think I know how you got there, and you might have taken the subtraction of 10 minus 6. That's a common error, which is fine, but hopefully you can understand why that's incorrect. So if I start at 6:50 and I jump to 7:50, this is what I was explaining, what I was doing in my head, then I go to 8:50. Then I go to 9:50. I'm going to squeeze this in here. It's been how many hours? 1, 2, 3 hours. So that's part of my answer. Now, of course, I stopped at 9:50 and I didn't try to go to 10:50 because we're not looking at anything past 10:50. We're looking at something in between 9:50 and our end time, which is 10:15. So now it's a matter of thinking about how many minutes are left over. Well, 9:50 to 10:15, we've already discussed several ways we can think of that, and I'm going to just take this from the comments. You guys are absolutely correct. It is 25 minutes that are left over. So altogether, the time that has passed by, or how long will it be until? It'll be 3 hours and 25 minutes. Beautiful. Let's do, I'm glad to see that many of you are understanding this. Very nice. Okay. So let's do maybe one more question. Let me pull up one here that, let's jump to the last one here. Let's jump to number 20 and then we'll end it off for the day. So you guys have a lot more questions that you can practice with. If you want to follow up on any solutions, reach out to your nearest Mathnasium. And then there's a full practice page after this. So let's jump to number 20 here. This will be our last question. If the current time is 8:30 a.m., how long will it be until the time is 2:10? So I wanted to end off with one of these where we're actually having to go between a.m. and p.m. And I promise you it's not super difficult. If you follow along with the problems that we worked on today, then this won't be too difficult. As long as you take the piece of information that a few of you have shared with me already, that let's say it's the morning time, it's currently 8:40, right? Once you get to lunchtime or noon, which hopefully you know that that language means we get to the 12 o'clock, you're no longer in a.m., you're now jumping to p.m. until you hit 12 o'clock again, which I'm not going to do here, but until you hit 12 o'clock again, which will be midnight, and it changes back, you know what, I might just make it. It changes back to a.m. Okay, so with every 12 hours that pass by, we move from a.m. to p.m. And I went too far. Or p.m. to a.m. Okay? So keeping that in mind, does it make too much of a difference to us here because we're being told that we're going from an a.m., so we're going from, if you really want to think of it this way, we're going from morning to the afternoon. 2:10 p.m. would be for us the afternoon. Okay, think about what you do typically on a morning at 8:30. Maybe you're eating breakfast. And then what are you doing? What are you doing at 2:10 p.m.? Maybe you're doing some schoolwork. Or you're listening to Mathnasium Schoolhouse, depending on what where you are in the country. Okay? So what time zone you're in. So if you go from the morning to the afternoon, how much time is passing by? Well, to get to that 12, let me write this here, that 12 o'clock p.m. moment in between it, we can count from 8:30 to 12 o'clock. That's pretty easy to do. 8:30 to 9:30 would be 1 hour. 9:30 to 10:30 would be another hour. 10:30 to 11:30 would be another hour. Then 11:30 to 12 is a half hour. So to get to here, we actually have 3.5 hours. Great. But we still have to add this leftover amount, which is, well, 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock is 2 hours. And then 2 o'clock to 10 past the 2 o'clock is 10 minutes. So how much time altogether, and I'm going to go to the comments to see if you guys can help me out here, amongst all the other comments I'm seeing here. I'm seeing 5 hours and 40 minutes, which is exactly correct. Let me give credit to Amita again. Very, very nice. Let me maybe squeeze this in here. So your final answer would be 3 plus 2, which is 5 hours. And a half hour, hopefully a lot of us understand that this is, another way to say this is 30 minutes. And using the law of sameness, we want to be able to talk about minutes with minutes, just like we did hours with hours. So if I take the half hour and rename that as 30 minutes, 30 minutes plus 10 minutes gives me those 40 minutes that Amita helped us out with. So to answer this last question of the day, of the schoolhouse lesson, if the current time is 8:30 a.m., how long will it be until 2:10 p.m.? It'll be 5 hours and 40 minutes. So if Sandra is eating breakfast at 8:30 a.m., and she is going to tune in to a Mathnasium Schoolhouse lesson at 2:10 p.m., she's 10 minutes late for some reason, she is going to have to wait 5 hours and 40 minutes for that to happen. I appreciate all of you that stayed on topic, helped me answer these questions. I truly, truly appreciate it. I really love to see us working together, so it's not just Sandra talking the whole time. And for those of you that are Mathnasium students, you'll definitely understand that that's a part of our program. We really want to make sure that you guys are helping us answer the questions just as much as we are helping you. So be sure to reach out to your nearest Mathnasium if you want more practice on this, maybe more challenging questions. We can do so much more with this topic on elapsed time. Just as I'm ending, I see a wonderful comment from Megan. She got the hang of time now. I love to hear that. Love to hear these schoolhouse lessons are, in fact, helping you out, especially on a Friday afternoon, at least in my time zone. I'm going to sign off now. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. Join us next week for more schoolhouse lessons. Have a wonderful weekend. As always, smile loads, stay safe, stay healthy, and I will see you next week. Bye-bye.
It's afternoons that seem to be the most hectic for us, so it was much more convenient when we found Mathnasium at home.
All right, so how do we do half of 5? I think one of the best things about at home is that it really feels like you're almost at home with the student in their house teaching them.
I'm in my comfort zone.
You can just ask for help and the instructor will come right to you.
With Mathnasium at home, I know that they're getting the help that they need.
Awesome, great job.
Mathnasium, changing lives through math.